Hello everyone. In this video, I'll be solving Cambridge A Level Information Technology Paper 4 for the year May June 2020. These are the files required for this task, and I have copied the files here. The first task is the graphics and the second task is the animation, which I have already done and uploaded. You can find the link in the description. In this video, I'll be doing the mail merge task, which is starting from step 3. So members.csv contains details of this membership. Open members.csv. So we have members, open this. Rename the worksheet as RPC members. So this is the worksheet. We have to rename this as RPC members. So RPC members. Save the workbook in spreadsheet format as RPC members followed by your center number. So save this as RPC members followed by your center number and candidate number, and it should be saved as spreadsheet. So Excel workbook. Save. The status of a member changes when they reach 40 years of age. Use the members data to identify all those members who will become 40 years of age during June and July 2020. So first we have to find the age of the members who will become 40 years of age during June and July 2020. So we have to calculate the age of the members by the end of July 2020. So the end date can be taken as 31st July 20. So first let us calculate the age of the members as on July 31st. So in order to calculate age, I'll be using date difference function, date and DIF. This function's format is not documented in this version of Excel. So the format of date diff function is start date, end date, and format. Start date means the date from which we want to calculate, that means the birth date. End date, in this case end date will be 31st July. And format is in which format you need, whether in years, whether in month or day. So we need the age, so we will give Y. If you give M, it will calculate the difference in months, and D means it will calculate the difference in days. We need the difference in years, so the format will be given as Y. So here I'll give the start date as the birthday. The end date is 31st July, so 31/7/2020. And I need the format. The format must be in years, so Y should be given in double inverted. All these are dates, so must be in double inverted comma. So you can see the age is calculated. So this is the formula which I have used, date diff. This is the start date, that means the birth date. Then this is the end date, 31st July. And the format which is required is Y, because I need the age in years. Now you can replicate this. So the age is calculated. Next, members are required to register a valid email address, but the pukmail and .git domains are no longer operational. So we have to check whether the domain is bookmail or .zit. Accordingly only we can set the conditions here. So first let us find the domains for each member. So you can see the email ID is given here. We need to find the domain separately, then only we can inform only the members who have .zit or bookmail. So in order to find the domain, we have to extract the domain from this email address. And you know the domain comes after the @ symbol here. So first we have to use a write function to extract all the text which comes after this @ symbol. So for that we need to know the position of @. So in order to calculate the position of @, I'll use the find function. Now find function is used to calculate the position of a particular text or character in a given string. So the format, you can see the format is find text. So what you have to find? So I have to find @, the position of @ within the text, within which text this is the text. And the start num means from which position you want to start. So here I will start from character 1. Give OK. So this is the position of @ for this email ID. So just let us replicate this. Now I'll find the domain using a write function. The domain is equal to write. So the text is this one. Now the number of characters. Number of characters is all the characters that comes after @. So if you subtract this number from the total length of this text, you will get the position from which the domain name has to be extracted. So I will give len function length of this minus this position. So this is the domain. So you can see the function is this way. The text is this one. The number of characters is length of this text minus the position of @. Give OK. So now you can see the domain name is extracted. So this is the formula which has been used to extract the domain. Instead of this one, you can directly use the find position here. That will also work. So now replicate this function to find the domain of all the members. Now we'll just go through the requirements of the letter. Use the status.rtf as a template to automate mail merge letters to members who will become 40 years of age in June and July. So we need only the members who will become 40 years in June and July. So those who become 40 years of age in before June and July, we need to discard them. So in order to do that, first let us calculate the month number here. So we can discard which is less than July can be discarded when you automate the letters. So equal to, I will use the month function here, month of this one. So we need only the ones in June and July. And the text for those with bookmail or .zit. So we have found the domain also. So let us save this file, and you can close this. Now use the status.rtf file as a template to automate mail merge letters. So let us open status. So this is the required template for mail merge. you can see we need to automate the mail merge to members who will become 40 years of age in June or July. So first let us link the letter with the source data. So for that, click on mailings, go to select recipients, use existing list. So this is the file which we had saved. So open this file, RPS member. So we have linked the source data with the document. Now we have to insert the fields. So here first one is insert member number. So go to insert field, member number. Then we need given name and surname. So given name, please maintain the indentation and spacing as given. Given name and then surname. Insert address fields as one field per line. So insert first street address. Town. Zip code. So the address has been inserted. Now let us insert the date using DDMMM format. So this is the long date format. So go to insert. You have date and time. So this is the required format. The third one, which is the long date format. And please make sure update automatically is ticked here. Next we have to insert the given name here. Insert conditional fields to display the text for those with an invalid email address. Now before doing this, we have to skip the letters for the members turn 40 before June or July. So for that, on mailings you have rules. In that we have skip record if. So skip record if the month, so select month, if the month is less than 6, that means we need only the people who are born in June or July. So less than 6 will give. So this is the condition for first skip record. Okay, then we have to skip the record if the age is less than 40. So skip record, go to age, age must be less than 40. Okay, so you can see the code for this. Right click, toggle field codes. So if the month is less than 6, the record should be skipped, and also if the age is less than 40. Now we have to include this conditional text. This is the text. This text should be included for the members whose mail ID ends with this domain. So let us give the condition for that. So this is the place where you have to insert the conditional text. So go to rules. We have if then else, if then else, if the domain equal to .jit.com. If it is equal to .jit, we have to give the text which they have given. So I have pasted that text here, you can see here, then give OK. So now you can see the text has been pasted here. So now let us go to the code. So toggle field codes, you can see here. So here we have to insert the email domain. We have to insert the email domain here. So from insert field, and give domain. Now just go to the code once more. So this is how the code looks. Now in the else part we have to check for pookmail.com. So same way we'll again give if then else inside this double inverted comma. This is the next condition. So if then else, if the domain equal to pookmail.com. The same text is inserted here and give OK. Now show the code once more. Now you can see this is the second condition where we have given for pookmail.com. So here we have to insert the domain. So select this, insert domain name. So now the final code should look like this. If domain equal to .zit, the text will be displayed and the domain name will be also displayed here. It will also check for pookmail.com, and if it is pookmail, the domain will be listed here. So please adjust the spacing. So this is the code. Insert the merge fields where indicated and save the merge document as RPC merge followed by your candidate number. So this should be saved as file save as. RPC is the name given. RPC merge doc. Followed by your center number and candidate number. Now there is another condition which we have to give. Our records show that you will turn 40 years of age and we have to insert the month here. So we should insert June or July according to the month number. So select this. Again I'll use if then else. If then else. So we are only taking into consideration the months June and July. So you can select here if the month equal to 6, it should be displayed as June. If it's not 6, it will be 7. So we will give July here. So give OK. You can see the code for this. So this is the required code for all the conditions. Now let us merge the document to get the required letters. You have to insert your candidate name, center number and candidate number. So just some formatting we'll give. The domain we'll just make it highlighted so that it is easily identifiable for the user. Only the domain and also the month. Okay, now let us merge the letters. Click on mailings, finish and merge. Give okay. So you can see there are 6 letters here. We need 6 letters. The letters with text added, you can see for the pookmail.com, and in June 40 years. This is without the text because their email ID is valid. This is also not with the added text. So two letters without text, and there are four letters with added text, which shows correctly which domain they are using and which month they are born in. So we should get six letters. So make sure the formatting, everything is done properly. It must be of standard format. So the letters are ready. These are the required letters. Now save this as RPC letters. So let us save this. We'll save as RPC letters followed by the center number and candidate number. Save the letters. Save a copy of your data source as merged data followed by your center number and candidate number. So these are the required letters. This is the file which I had used as source data. So let us make a copy. And it should be saved as. Merge data followed by your center number and candidate number. So these are the required files. So this is the end of the mail merge task. The next task is the web programming, which I'll be uploading soon. The previous task, the graphics and animation, is already uploaded. Please check the description for the link. So please keep watching my videos. Like, comment, share, and those who have not subscribed till now, please subscribe. Thank you for now.